This is so frustrating.
Hey man, what you up to?
What's up, bro? Just doing the statics homework. Have you done this problem yet? You have to, yeah, so you're given the system, you have to determine the components at B and F, but to be honest, I don't even know where to start.
I haven't, but do you know what? I know someone that gave me this video that might help us out.
Oh, really? Should we check it out?
Yeah, you want to check it out? Yeah, let's do it.
Alright, so what's the video called?
It's called Straight Out of Statics. It's on YouTube.
That's such a shame. Is this it?
Yeah.
Starting off by drawing those free body diagrams. Remember the difference between global and local.
Start with global, both moments and forces.
So pick a reference point.
And coordinate system.
Yeah, they call it moment.
What?
It's R cross F. Moment.
What?
Perpendicular distance. Then you move to the global forces. They say to get those equations X, Y, and Z. Equations laid out from left to right, but there are too many unknowns to find the rest. Choose a local analysis if you're stuck on the problem,
but check the support covered by your
free body diagram.
Plenty of paper to repeat it with the local,
but we gotta keep the sums in the local spot.
Local.
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 Calculate time.
No more unknowns.
We like solutions for the very good grades.
Yeah, now you solved it.
What?
Your problem is done. Finished.
Yeah.
No unknowns left. Variables.
And?
All forces known. Moments.
What?
The problem solved. Moments.
What?
Oh, that video helped so much. You got all the answers,
bro. Bro, I got you, man. I got thanks, you.
Thanks, bro. Thanks, bro. But those guys kind of looked a lot like us. I'm not going to lie.
Nah. They got beanies and they knew how to rap.
That's right. That makes so much sense.
Yeah. I got one more problem though.
No more problems?
Yeah,
I'm done, dude. Like, I'm ready for the test.
Lucky you.
Yeah, alright, well, just let me know if you need any help later.
I got you, man. I got you. Yeah, I'll catch you, man.
I got you, bro.
Hydrogen reactions. Unbelievable.
Yo, come here. Is he the dude from the video? Yo, are you the dude from the video?
No. It's Ryan.
Oh, what's good, bro? How are we doing?
Yeah, we're doing good. What's
dude,
up?
I'm stuck on this problem, dude. I'm trying to find the reactions for it, and I just don't know how to do it.
Dude, I was stuck on this one earlier, but I found a great video by Mr. Wilson.
Yo, what is it called?
It's called, just search for Mr. Wilson Statics YouTube.
Mr. Wilson Statics YouTube, what's spelled wrong?
Should be the first thing that pops up.
Welcome back to another class, and it looks like we have a great attendance here. Absolutely superb. So thank you all for showing up, I really appreciate that. My name is Mr. Wilson. And we already have a question? Yes.
Is that going to be on the exam?
This?
Yes.
Yes, this will be on the exam. Yes. I'm sorry, but yes, this will be a very difficult question. So please get this one right. This is free point. But anyways, today we will be talking about statics. And like any good professor, I have already come prepared and written a problem that we will be doing now. So we're going to start off this problem by finding the reactions at point A and B. So we've got point A here, which is at a roller, and point B here, which is at a hinge. We've also got some external forces acting on our body. We've got forces M, N, O, and F here, each of them acting at a different position, a different distance, and with a different amount of force. So first, before we start drawing our free body diagram, we have to come up with our convention and coordinate system. So we're gonna use the standard positive y is in the up, and positive x is in the right direction. And then we're gonna start off by drawing our free body diagram. And because our force is already on here, we're gonna draw the reactions at point A. So we've got a roller here. Class, do we know what our reactions at point A should be? Yes, Riley, thank you for volunteering.
Since it's a roller, is it going to be in the AY direction and AX direction?
Well, this is a very good guess, but actually this is a common mistake that students make. So yes, there should be a force in the Y direction that we'll call AY. But there should not be a force in the X direction named AX. There should be no force here. This is a common mistake because a roller, if you think about this marker as a roller, it can move in the X direction, but it cannot move in the Y direction. So we're gonna have a reaction force here, but it can move along the X line in coordinate system like this. It can roll. So actually we're gonna only have one reaction force named AY. So that was a very good. So just remember that for the exam. When there's a roller, we only have AY going up. So let's try point B, Riley. What do you think the reactions at point B should be?
I think those should be in the BY and BX.
Very, very good, Riley. That's very good. Yes, because this is a hinge, it's stable, so the reactions are BX, or well, this is BY, and BX here. So very good. There is reactions at both of those forces. Good job. So now that we've determined that BY and BX are acting at B, because there's two forces here, we'll take B and we'll use B as a reference point to take the sum of the moments. So now we know the sum of the moments is equal to zero, and we know that B is our reference point. Now, we also have to define a coordinate convention, and most of the time, people use the counterclockwise as possible. So now that we have all this information, we can go out and start writing down our forces and our sum of the moments equation. So sum of the moments at B is equal to. So we'll start off with this force, M. We have M times the distance. Now, Riley, what should the distance be here?
Shouldn't it be 10?
Well, that's a good guess, but another common misconception. Actually, distance is perpendicular distance because moment is defined as R cross F. So, in this case, R is the distance, and that's the 6. This is the perpendicular distance between B. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah, so that is why R is 6 and M is 10. So the distance here is 6. Now, in terms of direction, this is going to be pushing this body diagram like this. So this is going to be pushing it clockwise, so we're going to add a negative sign here to account for that. So next we'll move on to force N. So we'll do plus force N times the distance. Now again, this perpendicular distance, so since this distance is 10 and this is 3 meters from this edge, we'll be acting at 7 meters. Now again, we'll look at the sign convention, and since the body is pushing it like this, it's pushing it counterclockwise, so it'll be positive, so we can leave it like this. Move on to force O times the distance, 2 meters again. And again, pushing it like this, counterclockwise, positive. So now we'll move on to force F. Riley, how would we do this?
Professor, to be honest with you, I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, well, this is actually a hard question, and sometimes people get this wrong on the exam, so make sure you pay special attention. Force F is coming at an angle of 35 degrees here. So if I draw this out, we're going to split it up into the X and Y components, with this angle being 35. So, as a result, we know that this is 75.7. So because this angle here and this here, we can use simple trigonometry to get that this is, so a little mistake there, 75.7 times sine of 35, and here in the x direction to be 75.7 times cosine of 35. Does that make sense, Riley?
Yes.
All right. Perfect. So, because we're doing a force with reference to B, we know that this in the Y direction is going to have no effect because its distance is zero. However, in the X direction, we're going to have this force going right like this. And we'll call this Fx. So, we're going to say plus force Fx But remember, it's going to be 75 cosine 35. So we'll just write cosine 35 for now. And we'll plug in fx, or f after. And then the distance here, 1.5 meters. And again, looking at the sign convention, it's going to push it this way, which is counterclockwise. So we can leave that at positive. All right, class, this makes sense, right? Yes, Riley?
Didn't you forget about your AY force on the ruler?
That's right. You always got to double check to make sure that you've included all your forces in the sum of the moments. You're right. AY is acting at a distance of 10, so we really should add that on. Plus AY times 10. Then again, look at the sign convention. It's going like this, so that is clockwise. So we'll throw a little negative in there. Thank you for catching that mistake. Much appreciated. So now we'll go on to plugging all the numbers in and solving out what we can get to so far. So now that we've determined that AY is 8 kips, we can come over here and we can do the sum of the forces in the X and Y to figure out the reactions at B. So let's start off by sum of the forces in the X is equal to 0, with this way being positive. So let's look at our free body diagram and simply just do that. So sum of the forces in the X is equal to 0, which is equal to, when we go over here, we've got M, so 10, plus, look, N and O, perpendicular, no force, F. However, it's going this way, so minus, and then it's going to be 75.7 cosine of 35. Then we're going to get bx, so plus bx. Perfect. Then for the y, sum of the forces in the y is equal to 0, with up being positive. So sum of the forces in the y is equal to 0. Which is equal to, we've got AY going up, and we've just determined that AY is 8. So 8, got 3 going down, so minus 3. Also got 13 going down, so minus 13. We've also going down, we've got minus 75.7 sine of 35. And then we've got BY going up, so plus BY. Then we're going to solve out these equations. Any questions here? I don't know who to choose. Let's go with, I guess, you?
Yeah, I'm Riley.
Oh, Riley, that's right.
That's right, you know me.
Yeah.
In the sum of the moments, you had the distances. Why are there no distances in the forces?
Well, the forces is just strictly the forces, so it doesn't really matter where they're acting. As long as the direction is there, like as we can see N is going down, there's no distance. It's just that all the forces acting up have to equal all the forces acting down so that our body is in equilibrium. So we've determined all the reactions for our free body diagram to make sure that it's in equilibrium. Is there any questions here, class?
No.
Well, perfect. Sounds good. Thank you.
That video was really helpful.
Yeah, I know, and I saw it. It helped that problem, so it made that problem so easy.
You ready for the exam now?
Yeah, I am. How about you?
Dude, after seeing that, I'm pretty confident about it.
Yeah, so am I.
Yeah.
All right, I guess see you tomorrow.
Yeah, good luck,
man. You too.
Thank you for showing up to the exam today. I'm about to pass out the test, so please no talking, no phones, and good luck. Would you mind moving over a seat? I just don't want you to. Thank you.
Tough.
Hey, look, I'm sorry, man. I'm just trying to keep the integrity of the test. Thank you. Good luck. Good luck, sir.
Persecuted, under pressure, man, that's how we do it. We at war, but have you even looked at the scoreboard? Scoreboard, scoreboard, W's all day, what you scared for? Scared for, scared for, ain't nothing coming at us that we ain't prepared for.
Riley. I appreciate it.
So what do you think about the exam?
Honestly, with those review videos, I think I did pretty good.
Dude, same. Just there was one thing. I just didn't understand one question.
Which one?
It was the one where I asked for the professor's name.